Hello. Welcome to the 51st What the Flicks podcast. Okay, my name is Susan Ayers.
I'm Lon Shima.
Patty Smith.
Jorge Sanchez.
Yes, they are. Okay. So, except your phone is talking to me.
It's the evil phone.
Tonight we're going to talk about Stuck Together, Ghostbusters Afterlife, Coda, and Summer of Soul. So we're starting with, I guess, you, Lonnie.
Oh, okay. Yep. Stuck Together, film directed by Dany Boon and written by Dany Boon and Laurence, Arné.
Oh, so we're going to, I guess we're going to watch a trailer.
Yes.
Let me get that little guy going here. Yeah.
Je ne vais pas mourir du coronavirus.
Non, ma chérie, tu ne vas pas mourir. Ton père exagère, tu sais bien.
Mais pas du tout. Ça commence par un petit rhume, une grippette, puis après ça descend sur les poumons comme ça. Ça t'attrape, ça te serre, tu ne peux plus respirer. Et tu meurs et tout.
Non, Martin, stop, arrête là.
Non, attends, je n'ouvre pas. C'est le Covid.
Les enfants, ils vont pas y... Faut que tu reviennes, c'est le bordel ici, les devoirs, la bouffe, la concierge la pute. Je sais pas ce qu'elle fout, moi, d'ailleurs, cette conne.
Je suis Diego, le mari de Paola, la concierge.
Oui, je sais.
Tous dans le même immeuble, on sait même pas comment on s'appelle.
Moi, c'est Agathe, chanteuse, donc.
Ah, vous connaissez les chansons?
Ouais, par cœur. L'isolation est tellement bonne dans l'immeuble, on se régale tous les jours.
L'alcool, tu as petit feu, tant mieux. On n'est pas pressé.
Ils
ça pourra pas te faire de mal de tout se désinfecter.
Oh mon Dieu.
Putain, tu sais que t'es pas con. Avec la pénurie de gel hydroalcoolique, on va se faire des couilles en or.
Oh, they changed that, you saw.
Donnez, docteur. Ils aimeraient bien avoir des masques.
Il y en a plus, il y a pénurie. Et que tout le monde soit testé aussi.
Pourquoi faire?
Ça fait peur à les meubler.
C'est long, hein?
Oh, yes, right.
C'est dingue, il faut qu'il y ait un virus pour qu'on se rencontre enfin.
Quoi? Monsieur, je vois pas votre visage là.
C'est mieux là.
Meuble de taré.
The trailer pretty much represents the movie, yes, I think. Yeah. That's not bad.
Yeah.
So, Dany Boon is somebody I happen to really enjoy as an actor. He did something called, at least the American title was, Welcome to the Sticks. I think the French title is Bienvenue à Sticks. I thought it was so hilarious that I've tried to watch almost every movie he's done since. And so this came up, and I was surprised. I didn't know about it. And I thought, oh, it's also dealing with the COVID thing. And that's what sort of intrigued me, because I think this might be really the first COVID movie I'm seeing.
Yeah, I think.
So first of all, I had to admit, let's see how the French handled it. And I think one thing the film represents is it didn't matter who, where you are, everybody went through the exact same thing.
Yeah.
In this building, Patty was mentioning earlier that the French title was Huit Rue de l'Humanité, you know, which is basically the number 8 Humanity Street. So it's showing the people who are there, who are actually still there, because even the young boy in the trailer, you saw that, he is the son of one of the tenants. In fact, I thought he was very good. His name was Francois Damien. No, that was the father.
You mean that son?
That's Milo Machado Granier. I thought he was very good, and he sort of narrates at the beginning, so he introduces you to all the characters. Mm-hmm. Like, he says, I don't know who they are, I don't really like, or my father doesn't like them, so I don't like them either, but he likes the little girl that happens to be there. Yeah. And you just realize that, all these people sort of have nothing to do with each other, but they do have the one thing in common, Because one thing like they did in Europe that I used to see on the news all the time that I don't remember seeing here is when they'd go out on their balconies and applaud.
Yes, they did that here.
Mm. See, I've never heard that here. So, but I remember on the at least in Britain, France, Germany, and other European or Spain even, right? Italy, they were doing that. So that was something I thought, okay. And so it, how, that's how the movie starts. So you get to meet the neighbors, and they're just a collection of, as in most French films, very colorful characters. You have, first of all, Dany Boon and the writers of the film are playing husband and wife, that Laurence and Dany Boon. She's an attorney, he's a journalist, they have a young daughter. He is a hypochondriac. So he's the one who really just is the type that is spraying, wiping, you know, don't open the door kind of thing, as you saw in the trailer. I think what you see in the trailer is exactly what you get. Yeah. In fact, one of his get-ups, this film did make me laugh several times, and I'm going to spoil it because these are some of my favorite jokes in it. He actually gets dressed to go out, and he basically almost suffocates because he makes everything airtight. He passes out, and his wife has to take off his mask. There's a sequence where they're being tested, and I know he had to do because it's so true. Everyone knows how the discomfort of getting those tests done. So they just took it to another level. And then, you know, there's a neighbor. She owns a bar. It's sad because
She has clothes.
She doesn't have business. So she has all this alcohol she doesn't know what to do with. There's a young couple there. She's pregnant. She sings songs, and she broadcasts them online. And then her husband, boyfriend, I didn't even quite know if they were married, he works out. And so he does workout videos. But they have a tiny place, so they're constantly competing for space, you know.
Well, they're videos.
They're broadcasting live. That's why they were doing that. That's what makes me laugh. Yeah, they're doing streams like what we're doing. And they're almost, and it's funny because they almost get competitive about it. Then you have, who else? You have the mysterious tenant. No one sort of knows what she does, but she seems to be breaking the rules because she's always going out. And people are sort of reporting her to the police and everything, but no one really knows who she is or what she's doing. But they just see her leave all the time.
They say she's a squatter.
Exactly. Then again, like I said about the young boy, his family, their mother has left and gone to the country or somewhere outside of, I'm assuming, Paris, to be away from COVID, because he also mentions how several people just left to the country, that they don't want to be in the city for this.
Well, didn't she also leave because he's an asshole?
Well, that's sort of one of the things you believe, yes, because she did leave the two kids with him as well, which is sort of driving him nuts. That's the one thing, too. That's the one played by that Francois Damien, because he also was in a movie with Dany Boon, because he is Belgian, and it had to do with the French border and the Belgian border. You know, I don't know if you knew about that, and the conflict because of the different laws.
No.
Oh, okay, just because that's why I remember the movie so distinctly, because apparently in Belgium they have, I don't know what you would call it, but I want to say Deutsch laws or French laws. So at one point, depending on your borderline, a restaurant will be on the border. So at technically, the German site, you have to close by 10, but the other side will stay open. So it's that kind, and that's the kind of war they were sort of battling in that movie.
That sounds like a good
movie. And again, it's like picture them. City. Okay, there you go. Right. So again, picture the two. So they come up against each other because he's really funny playing this sort of unpleasant guy. Like I said, the wife is not there. The children, he's just buying their affection. But you saw in the trailer that he's like, he needs the concierge is not there. She used to she would do housekeeping for them and stuff like that. Since she's not there, it's only her husband filling in for her.
Diego.
So, yes. And that's sort of one of the cases of two, because he's a very important character, because he's dealing, because his wife has COVID and is in the hospital. So he's just sort of filling in for her. He doesn't really do too much for her. They are, I'm assuming, Spanish, because they do speak Spanish. Yeah. You know, that's the one thing I wasn't, it's like, well, it has to be Spanish. It's not like here would be Mexican,
it is, and I could talk they did that.
Right. Oh, okay, that's right. She says
Ofofina. But also, you notice when the landlord speaks to his wife right at the end,
right,
they also speak in a different language, which I'm not sure what the language is.
Oh, see,
Tony, I think it was some kind of Scandinavian language.
No. Okay. No, I didn't get that at all. So it's just about their dealings. And Dany Boon, like I said, is a great physical comedian. The one character that really surprised me was played by Eva Natale. He plays sort of a scientist doctor.
Oh.
And he has, again, my third favorite scene because him trying to revive a hamster had me laughing out loud. That I thought the was little so funny. No, exactly. That's exactly what it was. It was when he pressed down, the tongue came out. I said, that's really impressive. But again, I did not like the movie as much as his other films. And that's the thing that surprised me. I thought, oh, this got a little sitcom-y. What I did appreciate was sort of the drama involved with the COVID, because like I said, everyone's going to be able to identify with what everybody in that had to go through, whether you're pregnant or not.
I mean, one of the people in that group, one of the people.
You're going to identify with one of them. Somebody who's looking through financial failure because of business. My favorite being the young man who seemed to get depressed when his wife got more YouTube followers or online followers. And then you notice he starts eating and getting a gut. And like I said, he's the one working out all the time. I said, yeah, that's the story I always heard. My 10-pound COVID. He does
personal training, streaming show.
Exactly.
He's eating the eclairs.
So, you know, I would say watch it because I think it is a fun movie. And like I said, you can identify. It just shows you that COVID affected everyone almost the same way. And I'm sure it doesn't even matter what culture, language, where you came from. Everyone went through exactly what you see on screen. And you're going to be able to identify it.
Exactly.
Too.
Yeah. And you identify yourself and others.
Yeah, exactly. So true. I really love this movie. To me, the two starring people in it was Martin, the husband. Is that Dany Boon?
Dany Boon, right.
And I hope I say it, the doctor, Yvonne Atta?
Atal, yeah.
Right. Because they are the two comic reliefs, and everybody else kind of supports them. What I think is really interesting about all the movies we picked is they all have to do with family of some sort. This is the family in the apartment, and the other one's family, too. And so it's universal, and as you said, it could be anywhere, anytime, dark ages, 5,000 years ahead of time, people will still act like this. And what it was great about the movie is it really showed the range of emotions that people will go through when they're dealing with a heavy-duty issue. And also how your perception of somebody, like, you see a neighbor, you get a perception of them, and how it changes the more you get to know them. I thought it was funny as hell. Also, too, the ensemble was amazing because I felt that they had all lived there a long time but not known each other. Like, you just got that feel. You know what I mean? And you don't really know how long COVID's been going on.
I think it's early in the thing. Mm-hmm. The lockdowns were very severe in Paris.
But for no other reason to watch it, but it is a laugh-out-loud, ha-ha movie, which is rare for me, but I was ha-haing.
Oh, good.
Is the guy, Martin, who plays the hypochondriac, because we all know somebody like that, or we are like that, right? And the doctor. They are hysterical. And their facial matches their words. You know what I mean?
It seemed like they were both really physical actors. You know, physical comedy.
Comedy actors, yeah.
Okay. Good, Pat.
Yeah, I'm done.
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
Already. Yeah, I love the movie too. I was just, from the beginning, I was just cracking up the whole time. I was just laughing out loud.
No.
Every scene was just really funny, especially the hypochondriac guy, Martin.
Yeah.
And then and the doctor. Those were two that really got me the most.
Oh, wow, yeah.
They're very physical. Like he's testing out a vaccine, you know, that he's making, and he tested it out on himself and the side effects, and he's like, so she visits him and he puts on tango music or whatever, so she pretends that he's dancing. He's doing all his moves. Well, just very slapsticky scenes, like when he does a COVID test on them and the swab is that long. And you see him sticking it all the way
in. Exactly.
Like,
ah.
To the hypochondriac.
So it's very, I guess, working with the dog, and he keeps walking, and the dog's not there anymore. You see the dog running that way. It's just so many funny scenes.
Yeah.
Or I don't know if that's a spoiler, but the one where his wife is, you know, kissing another man. And he's like, he's a hypochondriac. He's like, oh, no, because he's seeing her.
He's going, Claire, no.
Not by the dumpsters. So, I mean, that was it. I think it really shows how everybody dealt with the situation differently. Mm-hmm. I thought it was really clever writing because the two things is to have all those different characters. And you got to know the characters really fast and really well. like you've been watching a sitcom or a series where you get to know them really well, but you get to know them really well, really fast. Their personalities, what they're into, what they do. And also like that you had the two, you know, the kids were really funny too, the little kid, Basil. He goes, Basil, the kid, not the dog.
Yes. I guess they both
had the same. His love interest, the girl, she has a dog named Basil. So he's like, I love you, Basil. He's like, well, but it's not him. Like, let's go, Basil. Now you're the dog. He goes, he'll be like, it's me. I'm the older Basil. But yeah, and they kind of show a lot of the kids. All the adults are going through all this stuff going on them, and the kids, like kids' movies, they really, they're in the little world, so everything can be falling apart around them, but they have their little world. So yeah, it's really clever writing. I really enjoyed the movie. Again, I was laughing, and I was laughing aloud, and I was silently weeping too. It had its moments, sweet moments. Yeah, I really loved the movie.
Yeah, it was such a surprise. It was such a nice surprise. I really liked it. I thought, oh my God, it's hysterical. Everybody can relate to this, like Patty said. You know, it's like so many different responses. Dany Boon, the director, is so funny. He's so hyper, everything, vigilant, hypochondriac. I was on the floor laughing. And the scene you were talking about when he's at the dumpster. And, you know, it's not that she's kissing another man. He's kissing her before.
Yeah, right.
But he can see that this is going to happen. And he's like, Claire, no, not the dumpster.
Not by the dumpster. It's almost like Barnes and Noble that they're doing it by the dumpster because of the germs. Yeah.
Laurence Amy plays his wife in this and plays Martine's wife. And she's also a co-writer with him of this thing. And I think they weave a seamless story just going from one. They do it like you get to know each separate person and then they go, their story is kind of, like a dance. Mm-hmm. Like, and they do it so well. Really good writing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I have to admit the one thing I'll interject because I think what Patty said was true was the ensemble cast, because you're right that since at one point they said, you know, we really don't know each other. So as an audience, we're getting to know them as they're getting to know each other. Yes. So that's sort of...
Well, I would say...
Think how many stories there are. There's like seven stories.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Well,
they all go together.
Yes. Yeah, like the boy, the young boy likes the girl and then one of the families. And so that's kind of a connecting part. And she has the dog that has the same name as him. It's just like so many, just very, very... Written very well. It's really good through the whole thing that we, during the whole COVID period, that we can laugh at ourselves, right? And possibly cry a little. Also, I think the title of the movie in French describes it better, Huitri de Humanité, which mm-hmm. means like Eighth Street, Humanity Street. And I think that really describes it well. Okay, so are we ready to... Yep. Okay, Pat?
You know, I would watch this movie. This is the kind of movie you can watch more than once. Yes. And you can go in anywhere and start watching it and be as funny as the first time you saw it. I'll give it an 8.
Oh, wow.
I really enjoyed it, too. I'll give it a 9. I really, it just cracked me up.
Yeah,
a classic comedy.
Yeah, oh as far goodness. As the comedy goes, I give it a 10. I thought it was one of the best comedies. And like Patty said, I can watch it over and over again. Love it.
Watch what you're giving it.
No, I just gave it a 5. I thought, it's an okay movie, but...
Mom, there are numbers higher than 6. Called 7, 8, 9, 10.
But I'm just so happy you guys really enjoyed it.
Like
I said,
yeah,
loved it.
But I will say this, Dany Boon does physical comedy, and so if you watch his films, I encourage anybody, watch anything you can with Dany Boon. Almost every time I watch this film, there at least is one or two scenes of, like you said, laugh out loud, funny, but also very physical comedian.
Very physical comedian. Yeah. Him and the doctor were both very
physical. Well, the faces are so expressive. Mm-hmm.
And his timing is just beautiful. Mm-hmm. His timing. That line that George was taking with him, myself too, I watched him do it perfectly. I was like, oh my God, that guy has perfect timing in delivering a joke.
Yeah.
You know, he doesn't rush it. It's just great. Anyways, so...
he wants to kiss her. He's taking her temperature.
She goes, are you taking my temperature?
Is it a bebop time?
Oh, yeah. We'll be back, man. Maybe in 2 minutes, perhaps less.
You don't have the sling?
Oh, yeah.
Can find it.
Oh, let's see if we can find it.